Hey everybody, how's it going? Happy Monday night. It's so good to see you. Welcome. Drop a line and say hello if you're joining. This week I'm talking about my song Anyone, Anywhere, Anytime. And if you've been watching these, you know that I'm very interested in a songwriting teacher named Pat Pattison, who teaches online courses. He teaches for Berklee School of Music and has some books and stuff, all of which I've read and worked through. And one of his, a lyrical writing concept that he is a proponent of is repetition. Anyone, anywhere, anytime. And groups of three are always good. So, I have been going through some personal things that I don't want to get into, but I was talking about them with Cassandra last week, and her response to me at one point, she said, "Don't blame yourself. It could happen to anyone, anywhere, anytime." She, at the mention of her name, she peeks her head in over here. Hi. And so that is where the idea of the song came from, Anyone, Anywhere, Anytime. And so I was working on it and I thought, the Beatles song, "To Lead a Better Life, I need my love to be here." Hey Blake. Each day of the year, on and on with the wave of our hand. I forget how it goes after that. But here, there, and everywhere. And that song has here running my hands through her hair. Each of us thinking how good it could be. Really know those chords could be, but each verse or each stanza here starts with here, and then the next one there, and then it ends here, there, and everywhere. So I kind of stole that idea for anyone, anywhere, anytime, using the three repetition, of three, and the first stanza starts with anyone. Hey everybody, and using the repetition, and then starting the first stanza with anyone, second stanza with anywhere, third, anytime. Then I wasn't going to add a fourth stanza because it's two stanzas for the first verse chorus, which is anyone, anywhere, anytime, and then the first stanza of the second verse, I was just going to make a one stanza verse two. But as I played through it, I thought, well, this really needs a second stanza for verse two. So I added a second stanza, which was any face. Anyone, anywhere, anytime, any face. and I came up with a couple different lyrical ideas. I ended up playing, obviously, one of them on the video. And I played this, the video I did, I played this on guitar, which I like, but I'm going to play it on piano today just to do something a little bit different. Another thing that I did that I was trying to, I've been playing a lot of like Joni Mitchell, right? And I was thinking about how like, I've been learning a lot of her songs, and I've always thought of her as she's a very sophisticated songwriter. But the songs of hers that I've been learning lately in particular are very beautiful in their simplicity as well, My old man, he's a singer in the park. He's a walker in the rain. He's a dancer.
keeping us tied into Rudo, my old man, keeping away my blues.
That whole thing, four chords in that whole thing. One chord, a four chord, a five chord, this kind of borrowed chord from relative minor, parallel minor. Like a flat seven, borrowed chord. Very beautiful in its simplicity. Song I played last week, I think. Wind is in from Africa. Last night I couldn't sleep. Oh, you know, it sure is hard to leave you, Carrie. But it's really not my home. Carry it out your cane. I put on some silver. Oh, you're a mean old daddy, but I like you.
Three chords again, you know, with a little bit of movement, diatonic movement down there.
Fours, you know, arm chords like that, but still beautiful in simplicity, pretty straightforward chord structures. And I thought, you know, I was working on a lot of ideas musically lately and working through all these key changes, and I was like, why just write something simple, just write something that's nice, it's easy, what are you feeling, just write it, you know, don't think too much about whether it's new or whether it's something different or whether it's, you know, not where the ear expects the, you know, the chord to go. Just write the thing. You can change it later if you want. And so the last couple of weeks, that's what I've been doing. And a lot of that is a product of, I mean, I did seven gigs last week, seven gigs in 5 days. And, you know, so the time I have had to be able to commit to sitting down and laboring over, you know, songs that I'm writing is more limited. And so it's like, oh, well, here's what my ear is telling me. Here's what I'm hearing. Here's the idea I have. I'm going to, that's the song now, you know. And it, I kind of like that restriction, like having the restriction of even, you know, be honest with you, even at some point kind of going, I get home from a gig on Saturday night with a couple of lyrical ideas and maybe an idea of melody or hook in my head. I mean, like, I'm going to write this song and record the video in the next 90 minutes, next 60 minutes, you know, and having that, you know, restriction kind of forces something out. Instead of kind of laboring the point, taking too much time with it, or what are all the different options I have? Let me explore all of them, which is good too, but it's just a different process. And, you know, I've heard a lot of artists say similar things, that, you know, having less to work with is actually a more productive creative environment, whether that less to work with means fewer instruments, fewer, you know, less accessibility or less, you know, tools to play with in the studio, less time, right? So, you know, that's true. And when I was in school, and this is something that a parallel that I've kind of connected myself, when I was in school, I definitely felt that way. I always wrote my term papers and stuff the day before they were due. I mean, I would spend a lot of time thinking about what I wanted to say, but, you know, a lot of the time I was writing long papers the day before they were due. That principle is in the essence of your teaching. Interesting. Yeah, right? You know, you set yourself a goal and you just get it done by the goal and then it's done, you know? Yeah, so that's, if you notice the last couple weeks, the songs have been a little bit simpler musically. But I don't think that's made them better or worse. I think they're just different. And I like that. So that, all that said, I want to say one more thing about the lyrics. I had a lopsided chorus, and I don't know if we could call the, you know, I actually don't even know how to label the parts of this song. You could call part of it a pre-chorus and then a chorus, or you could call just like a 7-line chorus. I can't be perfect, I've tried, but I don't expect me to be. Just let myself be. I'm not searching for a sign. Could be you, could be me, could be anyone, anywhere, anytime. That whole thing could be the chorus, or that those first 4 lines. I can't be perfect, I've tried, so don't expect me to be, but I can be worth it in time if I would let myself be. Could be a pre-chorus. If so, those final 3 lines, I'm not searching for a sign, could be you, could be me, could be anyone, anywhere, anytime, are uneven, unbalanced, sort of unresolved in the fact that there are 3 of them and the 3rd one is shortened. And I like that. It highlights the final lyric of that part, which is the title of the song. So I think that's appropriate, but also it feels uneasy, feels unsure. It lacks a certain confidence. And that's how I felt when I was writing the song. Kind of could, you know, reassuring, but sort of trying to talk myself into being reassured, not necessarily 100% believing the reassurance. So that said, here's my song of the week. Anyone, anywhere, anytime. I'm doing it on piano, and it goes like this. Anyone could be the one if the time is right, if the timing's right, when the light shines right, I know I'll know. Anywhere could be the place, standing in the sun, and all alone, be patient with love, and it will show. I can't be perfect, I've tried, and I don't expect me to be, but I can be worth it in time, if I would let myself be. I'm not searching for a sign, it could be you, it could be me, could be anyone, anywhere, anytime. Anytime could be the spark in the joy of June, beneath the autumn moon, the ripe band in tune can make hearts grow. Any face could be the face, any mended heart can be replaced under covers in the dark where young lovers go. We can't be perfect, we've tried, so don't
expect us to be. We can be worth it in time if we just let ourselves be. So stop searching for a sign. It could be you, it could be me. I'm not searching for a sign. Could be you, it could be me, could be anyone, anywhere, anytime, anyone, anywhere, anytime. That's my song of the week. Anyone, anywhere, anytime. Thanks for listening. And I have been, like I said, I have water here. I did 7 gigs this week. Thanks, Blake. And Dan, I see you're watching. David, if you're watching too, I know. I'm working on that album, man. I'm working on it. Like I said, I did 7 gigs this week. So I, thanks, Dad. I tried and I tried to learn some of the songs that came up last week. Trent, if you're watching, I missed, you threw a song out there and I missed it. It went right by. And I went through and I tried to find the spot in the stream from last week where it popped up, but I couldn't seem to pin it down. So that said, remind me. One of the things that I've been thinking about a lot with chords. Oh, hey, what's up? Old Pavian family. Love it. Keep pushing me on the album, man. I mean, I'm working on it. I'm working on Cassandra's EP right now, is where the majority of my recording energy is going into. But yeah, like I said, I did 7 gigs last week. I guess it, and I feel like that's an excuse, but I'm saying that only to emphasize the fact that that has been where a lot of my time and energy has gone. You know, summertime is busy. So, one of the things, thinking about chord progressions and stuff, like kind of like what I was talking about, is I've been thinking about how they're spaced out, you know? Like, one of the things that that song I just played, you know what? Actually, I'm going to draw attention to this since you brought it up. I'm a little bit... The Song of the Week mixtape. You know what? If you go to my YouTube channel, you can play. They're all on there. And there's more than just... This is Song of the Week number 45, which I should... Here, let me get rid of that title now, because we're beyond the Song of the Week portion of the show. You know. There we go. But there's like, I don't know, like 55 or 60 songs on there on the YouTube channel. So I... You go to my YouTube channel if you want to listen to them. They're all up there, as well as all of the live streams I've done as well, with the exception of a few where, like, they got messed up because I kicked everybody off because technology is not my forte. In any case, yeah, so let's talk about the shirt. I'm glad you brought that up. I wore this on purpose. My website is listentojohn.com. And you might think, wow, John, you got that shirt made for your website. But in fact, I did not. I got the website made because of this shirt. And my dad could tell the story. I received this shirt in the mail one day. It just said, "Listen to John." And I was like, "Well, that's an appropriate shirt." And my dad had sent it to me. And it was from a store, like a boutique, a local boutique. And they had shirts that just said, like, "Listen to John, listen to Bob, listen to, you know, musicians' names." John, supposedly being John Lennon, I would assume. But my dad got it for me and sent it to me because, you know, my name's John. So then I, you know, started wearing it ironically because I thought it was funny. A store in Santa Cruz. All right, perfect. That makes sense. That makes perfect sense. And it was a few years ago, I was on the bus, the Western bus, headed down to Riot Fest. And I was like, listentojohn.com. Listentojohn.com. It just has a nice ring to it. So I bought the domain right then and there on my phone. I'm obeying the shirt right now. Obey the shirt. Yeah. So this was in my clean clothes, and I thought, I'm wearing this on today's show. Listen to John. So yeah, thanks for noticing. So going back, I've been thinking a lot about how chords, not just like harmony, you know, not just the notes and how they're put together affect a song, keys and those types of things, chord changes, but the pacing of the chord changes. And that's something that, I mean, notice. Be the one, the time is right. I was putting that together, I was thinking about that. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's only three chords, but it feels like more is happening than is actually happening because of the pacing of the chords. I'm just thinking about that as I'm writing stuff. And I've been thinking about that in songs as well, thinking about the, you know, Bob Dylan, Joni Mitchell stuff that I've been playing on here and we've been talking about as well. But I wanted to play this song because I played it before. It's a beautiful song. But as I play it, I've been thinking about this as I was playing through it just for fun and decided to play it on the show tonight. And thinking about how the pacing of the chords change as go from the main riff to the verse and into the chorus as well. A lot of the kind of similar chords, but it feels very different because they're moving twice as fast or half as fast, depending on the section of the song. So here we go. Anyway, it was a long explanation to get into this song. I hope you enjoy it. Little Ben Folds.
Just did it wrong.
just to make it right and to leave myself behind. Yeah, I've been flying high all night. So come pick me up. I've landed. She made for nothing, so nothing ever made him right. She liked to push me and tie me back down till I believed I was the crazy one. And in a way, I guess I was, till I opened my eyes and walked out the door. The clouds came tumbling down. It's my check to see I'm troubled mine and leave it down behind. And I've been flying high all night. So come pick me up. I've landed. If you wrote me off, I'd understand it, 'cause I've been on some other planet. Yeah. Also, just that riff. What a great riff. Fantastic riff. It's nice, slow. And rocking. So anyway, I was thinking about that, and then 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, Yeah. Love it. Ben Folds. What's there not to love? This is another song I've been playing a lot lately that I love. And Cassandra. Cassandra, as I was playing through this. Yes. Totally.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
match, very much similar. Never really thought about that, but that's totally true.
Very awesome. Maybe we should play those. I can't do Bruce Hornsby without Cassandra, though. It'd be just...
Should we do some Pac?
I think we should. All right, Trent. We're going to do it. We're going off script.
We're going to do a little mashup. Maybe Cassandra will come help me out with this one.
Done this in a while, Trent. I wake up in the morning. Wait. I see no changes. I wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse than black. My stomach turns on me before a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a Negro. Well, the trigger killer, he's a hero. Give crack to the kids who the hell cares. One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First shoot and dope and let him get a breath. Give him pound, step back and watch a kid tell him. It's time to fight back. That's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead. Got love for my brother, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. Gotta start making changes. Never see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how it's supposed to be. Can the devil kill a brother who's close to me? But I'd love to go back to when we play as kids and things change. That's the way it is. That's just the way it is. Some things will never change. That's just the way it is. That's just the way it is. Some things will never change. That's just the way it is. Changes. All I see is racist faces. This place here is disgrace for races. We under. I wonder what it takes to make this one better place. Let's erase the wasted. Take the look at the people they'll be acting like. It's both black and white. We're smoking crack tonight. The only time we chill is when we kill each other. Take skill to be real time to heal each other. Although it seems heaven said, we are ready to see a black president. I ain't scared to conceal the fact the penitentiary's packed and it's filled with blacks. But some things will never change. Trying to show another way. Staying in the dope game. I tell me to be the only guy who killed a brother who's close to me. Easy way, I made it to you today. Put your meaning in a sleazy way. Sell the crap to the kids. I gotta get paid. Hey, that's the way it is. That's just the way it is. Some things will never change. That's just the way it is. He's still alive. He's out there somewhere. You gotta figure it out, man. He's alive on a beach somewhere drinking a Corona. Hopefully. Or he's alive somewhere up there on the beach drinking a Corona. Well, that was fun. Thanks, Trent. Thanks for bringing that up, David. That was a nice little woo. So, yeah, I'm gonna do this one on guitar. I
I have my backup guitar with me today, and apparently not my favorite guitar picks. That's okay. I have so many guitar picks lying around, and then, oh yeah, here we go. When you need them, you can't find them. But I was going to play this one on piano because I have before, but I've been doing a lot on guitar, and I really like it on the guitar. Nice. Bon Iver, Hey Ma, with Bruce Hornsby. Yeah. I've heard that. Or Phoenix by Red Machine just came out. I gotta write these down now because otherwise I forget, you know? So apologies for Hey Ma, Bruce Hornsby, and Hey Ma, Bon Iver, Bruce Hornsby. What's the other one? Phoenix by Red Machine. Red Machine. Cool. Love it. Very excited. It texts me for posterity. Hopefully. You can use strings on this thing. Close enough. All right.
Crystal raindrops fall, and the beauty of it all is when the sun comes shining through to make those rainbows in my mind. When I think of you sometime, I want to spend some time with you, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. Just the two of us, just the two of us, building castles in the sky, just the two of us, you and I. We look for love, no time for tears, wasted water's all that is, and it don't make flowers grow. Good things might come to those who wait, but not for those who wait too late. We gotta go for all we know, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. Just the two of us, just the two of us. Building castles in the sky, just the two of us. I hear the crystal raindrops fall in the window down the hall, and it becomes morning dew. And darling, when the morning comes and I see the morning sun, I wanna be the one with you, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. Just the two of us, just the two of us. Build
building castles in the sky. Just the two of us, you and I. I love that song. All right. Can we do a song from the vault? I think it's time to do a song from the vault. I was thinking about this one, and I love this song. It's one of my favorites I've ever written. And if you remember, I wrote it with my friend Hank Whitaker, and it is called Emily. And we're going to play From the Vault. I hope you enjoy. I can do it right. I can't do it right. I try not to kick everybody off. Here we go. All right, enjoy it. From the vault. Emily. 1, 2, 1. Thank you. kick anybody off. We're back. Good. I'm glad nobody got kicked off that time. Yeah. So, last week, Dan, David, you all asked for this one. Should we do it? Thank you, Blake. Yeah, that was recorded during quarantine. I recorded my part, and then Hank recorded his part from Los Angeles. So check him out, Hank Whitaker. And at the very end of the show, Hank and I we've done a full production of that song, and the structure is similar, but the vibe is a little bit different. And he did a really nice job producing it. So I'm going to play that at the very end of the show to take us out, if you want to hear it. So yeah, stick around for that if you want. But all right, we gotta do this. Zimmerman. Hell yeah. By the way, so I want to, since we were talking about Bob Dylan, I do want to play another Bob Dylan song. This came up. I was playing a gig on Saturday night, and
it's a place where they stagger the piano players. And I was doing the early shift, and it gets wild right before the end of my shift. You know, well, not right before, but it gets wild. And at about 15 minutes before the end of my shift, I'm trying to like just ramp it up, trying to make this thing 110%, just big, 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 big. Someone comes up with a request for a good amount of money and asks for the song, which is not a song that you ramp up to. And I'm trying to set up the room for the next piano player. I'm trying to, you know, pass off a nice room for the next piano player so they can have a good show. And like, well, yeah, money for this. I got to play it. It's a beautiful song. I played it. I played like an upbeat version of it. But we're going to do the Bob Dylan version. Yeah, totally. Adele really nailed it. Didn't he and Billy Joel do it too? I think they did. Oh my gosh. Wow.
We got time for one more.
Ooh.
I really want to play this next song. I hope you all enjoy it. talking about like kind of deep cut ballads of big time songwriters. I've always loved this song, and I rarely play it. I'll play it for you now, and I hope you enjoy it. You belong among the wildflowers. You belong in a boat out at sea. Sail away, kill off the hours. You belong somewhere you feel free. Run away, find you a lover. Go away somewhere all bright and I have seen no other who compares with you. You belong among wildflowers. You belong in a boat out at sea. You belong with your love. You belong somewhere you feel free. One of my favorites. Thanks y'all for hanging out with me and for the lovely requests and detours. Next week, got some Devo coming up for you, Blake. And check out that Bon Iver with Bruce Hornsby in the Phoenix. And as promised, I'm going to leave you with just the recording of Always Fun. See y'all Wednesday. I'm going to leave you a recording of the studio version of Emily that my friend Hank Whitaker and I did. And love y'all. Have a great week. Be safe. Be well. Take care. Thanks for hanging out. We'll see you soon. Here you go.
guess you got another plan to show me the door.
Love you. Have a great week. Take care.